So let's talk about Techline versus Danforth real quick. So it's a Mississippi case where it goes to the Mississippi Supreme Court. And so the reason why me and my group of scholars put Techline versus Danforth in the trifold is because of what the Mississippi Supreme Court justice wrote in the actual holding of Techline versus Danforth. If your mom or your significant other was pulled over and you wanted to pull over on the side of the road and you were going to cite Techline versus Danforth, why would you want to use Virgil A. Griffith's words? Well, why would his words have any weight or carry any merit constitutionally for you to be able to pull over on the side of the road if your mom or your brother or your sister or your best friend was pulled over and you wanted to film that interaction?
Because then if a cop arrests me for pulling over on the side of the road to film him, when I do go to court, what did the Supreme Court Justice of Mississippi write in Techline versus Danforth that I would go ahead and put it into the trifold for you to use if you see a cop on the side of the road and you could pull over and then interact with that cop?
Techline's Incorporated versus Danforth, 1943. Virgil A. Griffith delivered the opinion for the court. This case involves the proper and permissible interpretations of Section 90, Chapter 200, Law 1938, known as the Uniform Highway Traffic Regulation Act. The right to travel means, of course, the right to go from one place to another. It includes the right, one, to start, two, to go forward on the way, and three, to stop when the traveler's destination has been reached. To speak of the first two of these fundamental rights without including the third would be to descend again to the absurd. And so far as the instant case is concerned, that is what we have here. But we do not so limit the right. We affirm that it includes the right to stop on the way temporarily, for legitimate or necessary purpose, when that purpose is an immediate incident to travel. So, it is that the texts and authorities declare that the right to stop when the occasion demands is an incident to the right to travel. A proposition so completely self-evident that no authority is necessary to sustain it, and which we would pronounce irrefutable, had it never been heretofore been mentioned. But here are some of the authorities which do declare and sustain it. Blanchfield Automobile Law, Fulton County versus Chateau Counter Farmers, Morton versus Mooney, Albright versus Waterloo Construction. When, then, the right to stop is arbitrarily or unreasonably restricted or cut off by statutory enactment, the statute is objectable from the constitutional standpoint, as had the enactment prevented going forward. The right aforesaid being fundamental are constitutional rights, and while the exercise thereof may be reasonably regulated by legislative act in pursuance of the police powers of the state, and although those powers are broad, they do not rise above those privileges which are embedded in the constitutional structure. The police powers cannot justify the enactment of any law which amounts to an arbitrary and unwarranted interference with or unreasonable restriction on those rights of the citizen, which are fundamental.
If you see a cop on the side of the road and you could pull over and then interact with that cop. So why would I put that in there? Because of what was written in the holding. So without keeping you in too much suspense, here's what the holding says. According to the Mississippi Supreme Court Justice, I wish I knew his name. I don't know his name. I can't remember his name.
That man's name was Virgil A. Griffith. He's one of the best recognized figures in Mississippi legal history. His Mississippi Chancery Practice was among the most used books for at least two generations of Mississippi lawyers and is still consulted by many. The first edition was published in 1925. A second and subsequent 1950 edition lasted until the adaptation of the Mississippi Rules of Civil Procedure in 1982. He also wrote The Survey Work Outlines of the Law, a comprehensive summary of the major subjects of American law, 1949. Griffith was born in Lawrence County, the son of a planter. He graduated from the University of Mississippi in 1897, and then he read law in the office of A.C. McNair in Brookhaven. As was the custom of the time for aspiring young lawyers, upon admission to the bar, he moved to Harrison County, which remained home for the rest of his life. Griffith practiced law on the Gulf Coast, first with William Lyon Wallace and E.J. Bowers, a former congressman representing Mississippi's 6th District in Biloxi, and then with Judge James Neville in Gulfport. In 1920, Griffith was elected Chancery Judge of the 8th District. 9 years later, he was elevated to the Supreme Court of Mississippi, where he served 25 years, the last 2 years as Chief Justice. He died in 1953. Recognition of Griffith's influence in the field of chancery and equity practice abound. His Mississippi chancery practice was once termed the lawyer's Bible. While the ordinary practice among appellate judges, citing authorities for important propositions, merely gives the case citations, a Griffith authority was often thought to carry more weight when the court recited, "The court, speaking through the renowned late Justice Virgil A. Griffith."
He wrote that the inherent right to travel in the United States of America also means your inherent right to be able to stop. That's what he wrote. He said that if you can't stop, then you don't have a right to travel. Because what that would mean is that if you decide to travel, then you would only have the right to have the freedom to travel if you precluded, if you created a predestiny to where you were going, and you were only allowed to go from the point of origin to the point of which you traveled, then you don't really have a right to travel if you can't stop wherever you want or where a public easement exists for you to be able to stop. Now, with those words written by that Supreme Court Justice of Mississippi in 1943, I would be more than willing to go to court and take that Mississippi Supreme Court Justice's argument that we don't have an inherent right to travel if we don't have an inherent right to stop. That's all I'm saying. Does that make sense to you? So you can read the holding.
Can you read or not, Randy? Can't read it.
I can't read.
You can't read.
I can't read.
Did you read the holding?
The man was an absolute legal genius. I stand by recommending TechLines versus Danforth. Use it. And don't be afraid if you go to court to recite the old lawyer's Bible, good old Virgil A. Griffith. Virgil stood strong for the principles of liberty, for the right to travel also means the inherent right to stop. Let freedom ring. Rest in peace, brother.